Let's see for acidic substances, how to find out the equivalent weight. Equivalent weight of acid equals to molecular weight of acid by its n factor. Here n factor means basicity. N factor means basicity. What is basicity? For an acid, you know, the total number of hydrogens present in acid is not equal to its basicity. Some acids have the number of hydrogens basicity same, but for some acids basicity number of hydrogens are not same. It depends on the structure of the acid. First say, what is basicity? Basicity means the number of replaceable hydrogens of an acid. Number of replaceable hydrogens of an acid. See an example, HCl, if you take HCl, it's an acid, na? It can give one H plus ion. That means its basicity is 1. H2SO4, it can give 2 H plus ions. So its basicity is 2. Why? It can give 2 H plus ions, that's why. Similarly, for H3PO4, it can give 3 H plus ions in its reaction. That's why its basicity is 3. So here what we observed is number of hydrogens present in the acid is equal to its basicity. But in some acids, number of hydrogens present is not equal to basicity. See such examples to H3PO2, its name is hypophosphorus acid, but you know it can give only 1 H plus ion. That means its basicity is 1. Why you think that there are 3 hydrogens, why it is giving only 1 H plus ion? Always in acids what happens is basicity we derive from its structure. If you take H3PO4 structure, this is the structure of H3PO2. So H, this is the structure for H3PO4. Here see, number of hydrogens on oxygen only liberated as H plus. These hydrogens which are attached directly to the phosphorus element are not liberated. That's why even though this formula contains 3 hydrogens, it can give only 1 H plus. That's why its basicity is only 1. Similarly, if you take H3PO3, it is orthophosphorus acid. There, how many hydrogens? Total 3, but basicity is not 3. There are 3 hydrogens, but it can give only 2 H plus ions. How can we say? Using structure. See the structure of this orthophosphorus acid. P double bond O, OH, OH, this is H. H3PO3. How many OH groups there are? Only 2 OH groups. That means these 2 hydrogens can be liberated as H plus. So even though there are 3 hydrogens, it can give only 2 H plus ions. That's why its N factor, that means basicity, is 2. So in that way, see one more example, acetic acid, CH3COOH. See, in this acetic acid, how many hydrogens there are? Total 4 hydrogens. But it can give only 1 H plus. That means basicity is 1. Why? See from the structure. This is the structure of hydrogen, acetic acid, CH3C double bond O, OH. So how many OH groups are there? 1 OH. So hydrogen on that O only liberated as H plus, not these 3 hydrogens. That's why its basicity is 1, that means N factor is 1. So in that way, we calculate equivalent weight of an acid. So finally, see equivalent weight of H2SO4 is equal to its molecular weight by 2. H2SO4 molecular weight 98 by 2, that means 49. Similarly, equivalent weight of H3PO2, already I explained about this. H3PO2 is hypophosphorus acid. Its basicity 1. So its molecular weight by basicity 1, that means molecular weight. So equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight, where when n factor is 1, then equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight. So in that way we can explain the basicity of an acid. See, for the third case, how to find out equivalent weight of a base? You know, for a base is molecular weight of base by its n factor. Here in place of n factor we take acidity. For an acid we use the word basicity, for a base we use the word acidity. Acidity means number of replaceable OH groups of a base is called its acidity. Let's see some examples. See, NaOH, it can give only one OH minus ion, that's why its basicity is 1. If you take barium hydroxide, here barium hydroxide, its basicity is 2. Why? It can give 2 OH minus ions. So in that way we can find out the equivalent weight of a base. See, equivalent weight of NaOH equals to its molecular weight by 1. Similarly, equivalent weight of barium hydroxide, equivalent weight of barium hydroxide is equal to its molecular weight by 2. So in that way we find out acidity of a base. If individual acid or base are given, we use these formulae directly. Sometimes some reactions will be given. From the reaction, how to find out the equivalent weight and n factor? So for that, see, H2SO4 plus NaOH gives rise to Na2SO4, H2SO4 1 mole, NaOH 1 mole. These two are reacting. Here the formed products are NaHSO4 plus water. Now the question is, what is the equivalent weight of H2SO4 in this particular example? That is the question. Already I said, for H2SO4, n factor is 2. That's why its molecular weight by 2. That we use that formula when individual acid is given. But here, individual acid is not given. H2SO4 is reacting with a base. See, in this reaction, how many hydrogens of H2SO4 are replaced? Check it once. Here, 2 hydrogens. Here, only 1 hydrogen. That means, one of these 2 hydrogens of H2SO4 is replaced by sodium. That means in this entire reaction only 1 hydrogen is replaced. That's why even though basicity, maximum basicity of acid is 2 for this H2SO4, here molecular weight by 1, that means 98 only. Earlier I said that H2SO4 equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight by 2, but here I used only 1. Why? Because in this reaction H2SO4 uses only 1 hydrogen, that's why. Similarly, for a base also, see some example, HCl plus some barium hydroxide, let us take. So in this reaction, BaOHCl plus H2O. Once have a look on this reaction. In this reaction, my question is, equivalent weight of barium hydroxide is how much? Already I said the formula to find out the equivalent weight of a base. What is the formula? Equivalent weight of a base is equal to its molecular weight by acidity. Barium hydroxide acidity is 2, maximum acidity 2. But in this reaction, see how many OH groups of base are replaced. Check it once. Barium, initially it is having 2 OH groups, but here 1 OH group is left over, only 1 OH is replaced. So in this reaction, number of replaceable OH groups are only 1. That's why here its molecular weight by 1, that means molecular weight. So in that way, for HCl, we find for HCl reaction, HCl and barium hydroxide reaction, we got E barium hydroxide is equal to molecular weight. Similarly, for H2SO4 NaOH, this given reaction, equivalent weight of H2SO4 equal to 98. So based on reaction, based on the condition, equivalent weight changes. So equivalent weight of a substance is not fixed, it's a variable term. But molecular weight of a substance is fixed. NaOH molecular weight, it is 40, always 40. Whatever be the reaction, whatever be the nature, whatever be the condition given, NaOH molecular weight is fixed, but equivalent weight is not fixed. So NaOH, for NaOH, it is a monoacidic base, that's why it may be fixed. But if you take some polyacidic bases, that means barium hydroxide, aluminium hydroxide, if you take na, they will have different equivalent weights based on the reaction conditions. So this is about a base. Similarly, for a salt, how to find out? Fourth factor, fourth substance for salts. Here, equivalent weight of a salt equals to its formula weight by N factor. What is formula weight? It is just like molecular weight. You know, we use the term molecular weight for molecular substances. H2SO4, glucose, methane, NaOH, these are molecular substances. They contain molecules. But NaCl, sodium nitrate, barium chloride, these are not molecular substances. These are ionic pairs. For ions or ionic compounds, we use the term formula weight. Formula weight calculation is similar as in molecular weight form calculation. But only thing is, we use the word differently for ions and salts. That word is formula weight by N factor. Here, what is N factor for salts? N factor for salts is charge of all cations or anions of the given salt. Charge of total cations or total anions of the given salt. See some examples. Equivalent weight of NaCl, how to find out? NaCl, its formula weight. You know, NaCl formula weight is 58.5. Why? NaCl in sodium 23, chlorine 35.5. These are atomic weights. If you add these two, you will. So don't use the word molecular weight of NaCl. Why? NaCl is not a molecular substance. It's an ionic compound. So for ionic compounds and ions, we use the word formula weight. So formula weight of NaCl is 58.5, and charge of either cations or anions. Check it once. In sodium chloride, what is the charge of cation? Plus 1. What is the charge of anion? Minus 1. Here we don't take the sign, only magnitude only we take. So magnitude 1, that's why 58.5. So here equivalent weight is equal to formula weight. Why? There is a N factor 1, that's why. Similarly, equivalent weight of some AlCl3, how to find out? It's a salt. So how to find out? So it's a formula weight by, formula weight how to find out? Aluminium atomic weight 27 plus 3 into atomic weight of each chlorine 35.5. So 27 plus 3 into 35.5. So that will give its formula weight. So formula weight by, what is the N factor for this salt? So this N factor is, its N factor is AlCl3, you know, it ionizes to Al3 plus and 3Cl minus. That means in AlCl3, see, one aluminium ion, three chloride ions. You can take charge of any ion. If you take the charge of cation, there is 3+. 3+ means charge 3. Or you can take the charge of total anions, that means minus 3. So here I said earlier that sign we don't take, only magnitude we take. That's why formula weight by 3. Similarly, what is the equivalent weight of carnallite? Do you know what is carnallite? Carnallite is a mineral of magnesium. See, KCl, MgCl2, 6H2O. This is the formula of carnallite. KCl, MgCl2, 6H2O. It's a double salt. Double salt means, see here, how many salts? KCl one salt, MgCl2 another salt. So it's a double salt. So for this double salt, how to calculate? So equivalent weight of carnallite is equal to its formula weight. Formula weight means KCl, molecular weight, formula weight of KCl plus formula weight of MgCl MgCl2 plus formula weight of 6 water molecules. Sum of these three terms gives the formula weight of entire salt by its n factor. So n factor how to find out? From KCl there are K plus and Cl minus. From MgCl2 there are Mg2 plus plus 2Cl minus. Water doesn't give ions. That's why total cations here, one potassium ion, one magnesium ion. That means here plus 1, here plus 2. Total charge plus 3. That means n factor is 3. From anions also we can take. How? Cl minus, here 2Cl. Total 3Cl minus ions. The charge of 3 chloride ions is minus 3. That means 3. So in that way we calculate the equivalent weight of a salt. So after that, see similarly, what is the equivalent weight of FeSO4? FeSO4. Here FeSO4, how does it ionize? Fe plus 2, SO4 minus 2. So its formula weight by 2. So this is the formula to find out the equivalent weight of a salt. So fifth one, how to find out the equivalent weight of oxidant. How to find out? What is oxidant? Oxidant means any redox reaction which undergoes reduction. Redox reaction means we have different types of reactions. In some reactions, you know, there will be no change in the oxidation states of elements. Those are called non-redox reactions. In some reactions, there will be change in the oxidation state. Such reactions in which both reduction and oxidation take place simultaneously are called redox reactions. So in that, what is oxidant? Oxidant means which undergoes reduction. Let's see some examples. KMnO4 is the frequently used oxidant in organic chemistry. KMnO4 is the frequently used oxidant in organic chemistry. Let's see how to find out its equivalent weight in different cases. This KMnO4 acts as oxidant differently in different media. That means in acidic medium, in basic medium, in neutral medium, it behaves differently. See, first case, in acidic medium, what is its change? Acidic medium. In acidic medium, you know, this MnO4 minus, where manganese is already having plus 7. In KMnO4, what is the oxidation state of manganese? Plus 7. It is changes to manganese plus 2. That means, how many electrons are involved in this reaction? Plus 7, plus 2. There is difference 5. So 5 electrons are added up. So manganese here takes up 5 electrons to give its ion. That means number of electrons gained, 5 electrons. So equivalent weight of oxidant, how to find out? Its formula weight by number of electrons gained, number of electrons gained per molecule. That is the formula. So using that formula, equivalent weight of KMnO4 in acidic medium is equal to its formula weight. Formula weight of this KMnO4 is 158. 158 is the molecular weight. How to calculate this one? See, KMnO4, potassium 39, this manganese 55, 4 oxygens 4 into 16. If you sum up all these, you will get 158. So 158 by 5. Why did I write 5 here? Number of electrons involved here, 5. Plus 7 minus 5. Plus 7 minus 5 means plus 2. That side also plus 2. So this is in acidic medium. Second case, in a strongly alkaline medium, strongly alkaline or basic medium, here what happens is manganese plus 7 changes to manganese plus 6. Manganese plus 7 changes to manganese plus 6. There how many electrons are involved? Plus 7 plus 6, difference 1. That's why one electron is take up by manganese ion. That's why here equivalent weight of this KMnO4 in a strongly basic medium, strong basic medium is equal to its molecular weight 158 by 1. Similarly, third case, in a neutral or dilute alkaline medium. See the change here. In this case, manganese plus 7 is changed to MnO2. Yeah, in MnO2, what is the oxidation state of manganese? Plus 4. So, plus 7 here became plus 4. That means number of electrons involved, 3. Difference is 3. That's why 3 electrons. So, here equivalent weight of KMnO4 in this case is equal to its formula weight 158 by 3. So in that way, in different media, KMnO4 equivalent weight is different. In acidic medium 158 by 5, in strongly alkaline medium 158 by 1, in a neutral medium 158 by 3. Okay, this is the way of calculation of equivalent weight of KMnO4.